We're going to be two videos this week. One of them is going to be a video on, well, this video is on some recent finds. And then the other one is going to be on some more recent finds today, this afternoon. I'm going to go pick up a TV and hopefully a couple radios. Anyways, we were clearing out an abandoned house, and I decided to grab some stuff that was going to go to the dumpster. Don't really know why, but stand by. Here's a Sony HP250, and this kind of worked. Everything was super dirty on it, and I wasn't really receiving hardly anything. I got something on AM, but it was real quiet, and the tuning string broke. Well, it didn't break, it's just slipping. The phono was dead. Tape in was dead. All these switches were just dirty as hell. And the phono cartridge, the tone arm has been broken off. It'll still go back on, it'll take some force. And the wires are cut here. And this whole thing is just in sad shape. It says AM FM, stereo, missing the knob. It's got A and B speakers, so. And here is an Emerson. Probably from the early 80s, I have something similar to this. 8-track. 8-track was dead, radio was dead, everything was dead on this. Got absolutely no life at all out of it. This is missing the locking device for the tone arm and the needle. The cord was cut. And this was out of an Admiral console from 1959. The console was completely rotted away. It was just the record player, the speakers, and the chassis, so I just grabbed the chassis.
Country 107.3 W3D. I've got perfect
playlist. This was broken, the tuning string.
I just like the music.
That's Q106.
And freshly cut cornfields.
It's a good song.
Does the smoke in your mirror get clear?
I aligned it. So what? The first thing I did was I just cold turkey just plugged it in, just to see what happened. And the rectifier started making all sorts of pretty colors, and then the glass cracked. Tube socket's bad. And it started making all sorts of pretty colors, and then the glass cracked, and it was just a defective rectifier. I popped this one in, and it started working fine. I got no audio out of it and scratchy controls, so I cleaned all the controls, and I went through, and every single one of these tubes is labeled Admiral except this, which is a Philco, which is literally older than the set. I went through and I cleaned all the pins and checked all the tubes. And I believe this one, the replacement, checked weak. But I just left it in there because it was a 6AU6. And both of the outputs checked less than 10 on my meter, on my tube tester. And I just kind of wondered why for a second. And so I popped new ones in, and sure enough, it brought it to life. And for a split second, then the audio output transformer started arcing. The left channel. This one is good. This is the right channel, that's what you're hearing. So I literally just cut the transformer out, because it was loading down the circuit and making the other channel quiet. So you're wondering why these are back in here. Well, I remembered a story that somebody told me about audio outputs in some other power tubes. If they've been sitting for a long time, especially in open environments, that filter's quite warm. They'll get something called cathode saturation. And I remembered somebody telling me, like, well, you gotta bake them at like 8 volts or 9 volts for like 24 hours. So I went and I hooked one up to my variac at 9 volts and one up to my DC power supply at 9 volts. And I let them run overnight. You can see where it burned my paintbrush. And sure enough, that got them to go. These are Amperex tubes, that's why I wanted to try to save them. Deacon Blues by Steely Dan. So 6BQ5, 6BQ5, 12AX7, so it's preamp output. 5U4 rectifier, 6AL5 ratio detector for the FM. 6AU6, 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 6BE6. Some weird tube I've never heard of. 6DT8. That's the FM converter. And they use a 12AT7 for the, I can't remember why it uses two of these. One's the mixer oscillator, one is the FM converter. That's the AM converter, 6BE6, and then just IF right here. This is all the AU6s. But kind of sad that this transformer shorted. I was going to make a cabinet for this and kind of use it, but there's not really any point now. I never put these back in the tester. I wonder what they test. One of them was shorted for a little bit. The short cleared. So 6BQ5 or EL90? EL85, 84, close enough. So 6BQ5, 33122. I already have it set. because I was testing these earlier. Now this is the one that's not in use. Oh, it's got some grid leakage. That's probably because it's running it, since there's no load on it, it's running it quite hot. There, it went away. And yep, it's gonna back off, but it's still, well, it didn't back off that much. And this one sounded a little distorted. That's why I have it on the other channel. So I don't know if it fixed this one. This one might actually have a short in it. I can't remember which one did. Ow. That's hot. No grid leakage. See, I don't know if this is right, though. Because these, I had these... The brand new one's test brand new, but, you know, it was running and you heard it. It didn't sound bad, but maybe I need a second opinion on this. Let's see what else we got going on here. Jessica. What happened? Why is it quiet now? Oh, I have the wrong tube. Apparently not. Why is it now quiet? It's distorted. There it goes. I want to get a second opinion on this. Okay, let's have my mutual conductance tester. Come on, damn it. Yeah. Really, instant. 6BQ5, 24, socket 24. That's better. A26. Shorts are gone now. No grid leakage. Wow, it checks on this tester too. Completely dead. Just crank it up. Ooh. Cooking now. Drop it down. I guess they just really ran the life out of these tubes. Grid emissions are starting to climb too. Yeah, they just absolutely ran the life out of these tubes. Now you can get loud with this one. It's just a run for a little bit. I want my music back. Microphonic. That one's starting to cook. No grid leakage. And see, same way. So it doesn't even check weaker. Yet this one is super quiet. I don't know, I'm not putting new tubes in here. Oh, this is grid leakage. Oh, I'm a complete dumbass. This is a mission. So that's grid leakage. This is a mission. The tube is that dead. Wow, that's actually surprising. Would expect this one to have some sort of life. It's producing sound. Wow, that's insane. Just run the life out of. That's pretty cool. Anyways, so much for trying to save some Amperex tubes. Those are, they're just dead, baked. No longer. Baked like a toddler in a hot car. Anyways, you'll be seeing videos coming up on these soon. Resurrection videos or repair. Probably repair on that and a resurrection on that. I don't think this record changer is ever going to play again. It's pretty bad. I can try, and I'm pretty good with record players, but I don't know how good I am with stuff like that. You know, left outside for 15 years. Anyways, thanks for watching. Here's that tube again. Yeah, I'm probably just gonna jump these. Anyways, thanks for watching.